Hi Pisces, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and let's do another energy check-in for you, Pisces. Let's see how you're doing, how your partner's doing, and what are the energies that are aligning you guys today. So these are general collective readings, will not resonate with all of you. Take what works for you, okay? Leave the rest. So my angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for my Pisces gang and send them the messages they need to hear the most right now. Thank you. So Pisces, let's get on with your reading, and I'll be doing two sides, person A, person B. You will know which side you belong to, right? What side resonates with you. The first card I have here is the Fool in reverse, Ace of Swords, Justice, Two of Pentacles, the Tower, and the Six of Swords. For person B, Nine of Wands, Strength, Six of Pentacles, Page of Cups, Death, and the Knight of Wands. Bottom of my spread, I have the Empress. All right. So let's see what is the action person A would take if they could, and what action would be coming from person B's end. Now we're all set to go. Let's just start with some dialogue message cards and see what the problem is here. But from the overview gist that I get right now, I think person A is feeling, they're feeling like a fool. Somebody's feeling like a fool because they have no clarity now. Maybe they said some lies, or some lies got caught, or maybe they don't know now whether there is going to be a fresh new beginning between the two of you, because person B has stopped fighting for the connection. Person B is now stronger, is holding themselves back, and person A is very confused right now because they don't know whether there is a chance of, you know, this going forward. So let's see. If they could say something to each other, what's the underlying problem here, Spirit? What's the problem in this connection? What's going on? What's going on in this connection? Thank you. Let's take a couple from here. Pisces and that person, Spirit. Pisces and that person. Pisces and that person. All right. And I'm going to take a couple more from here as well. Pisces and that person, Spirit. Dropping a few cards, I've just picked them up. One more. Okay, thank you. Just give me a second. Okay. All right, Pisces, we're good to go. Let's start with the dialogue message cards and see what's going on. I eventually had to let go in the physical world because the pain became too much for me to bear. My emotional, mental, and physical well-being became affected negatively. I'm still fighting my inner demons where I felt that I wasn't good enough for you, and guilt of wondering if I walked away too soon. This is really hard. This is very, very emotional, because one person is saying, hey, you know, I couldn't take this kind of pressure anymore. I started doubting myself. Maybe I'm not good enough. Why would you not care for me? Why would you not commit to me? Because I think this is person A who started feeling maybe there's something wrong with me. Why doesn't my person love me? Am I not good enough? And it started affecting them in a very bad way, like maybe physically as well, emotionally, mentally. And they're saying that's why I eventually had to let you go. See, I'm still fighting my inner demons. Wondering now if I walked away too soon, should I have fought a little longer? No, not at all. You've, I think, done the right thing. Love should be easy. Love should be smooth. Love is not something that makes you feel bad about yourself, Pisces, if this is you. I can't wait to lay my head on your chest and listen to your heartbeat. So the love was there. I tried to walk away from you, but something keeps pulling me back to you. Still dealing with inner demons here. Still feeling maybe we walked away too soon. Or maybe now this is the other person getting pulled back because you've pulled your energy away, Pisces. I really didn't think we were compatible at first. I see that we are now. Distance, I think, is making the heart grow fonder here, Pisces. So whoever has walked away, stay gone for some time. Let the other person realize your worth. When I said I love you forever, I meant it. I'll always remember you. You are unforgettable. I let my temptations get the best of me. I got sidetracked. Maybe they took their partner for granted. Maybe they felt, you know, the grass was greener on the other side, or other things were more exciting at that point, and they didn't give that respect they should have to the relationship. They let their temptations get the best of them and got sidetracked from this connection. Missing you so much, we truly did have something special. Okay, so now I'm going to take one angel blessing card to bless this reading, Pisces, and then we clarify the cards. My angels, blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for this reading, please, for Pisces. Speak your truth. Absolutely correct. What you're doing is the right thing. Stand up for what you want. You have to be an empress to do that, right? Whatever that's solitude, whatever time you spent by yourself, I think it's actually grown you to be an empress now, Pisces, or cross watcher, I don't know who this is, but yes, it's now time to stand up for yourself and not doubt yourself anymore. Okay, so let's see. Person A, these two cards, Pisces, I'll open later. These are the actions you'll take towards each other, expected. So, why is this person feeling like the Fool in reverse and the Ace of Swords in reverse? They're feeling foolish at their own mistakes now. They're feeling so foolish that they kind of maybe didn't speak up. They didn't speak their truth when the time was right. And now this the relationship is not moving in any direction. They feel maybe earlier they were kind of being a bit defensive, not allowing their partner in, and now they've started to feel that their partner's doing the same thing, and they don't know how now, what to say, what to speak, and how to get back on track. Yes, they feel that person is now no longer giving of their love, their affection, their nurturing, their caring, and this is confusing this person more and more, because now they don't know with what words can I come in. Yes, this person is stuck now. They are in hangman's position. They don't know now what to do to get things moving again. They don't know how to make things work between the two of you again because of something that happened in the past. Now, what happened in the past was somebody didn't do justice. Maybe they were juggling. They were not giving a direct answer, maybe. Two person B, always keeping them on and off and not doing the right thing. So Spirit, what happened in the recent past for this connection to reach the stage? Justice in reverse. Yes, I think some truth came out. Somebody didn't do the right thing and some truth came out about this to both of you, which made their partner walk away from the connection. So what's this Two of Pentacles, Spirit, in the recent past? Two of Pentacles. Somebody decided not to get juggled anymore. Somebody decided, I don't want to have an in and out kind of relationship. Maybe they felt that maybe this person was seeing other people or being immature and not kind of stepping up to the plate. Right, being a very, very immature energy, and somebody walked away from this connection and decided, I don't want to be in this very imbalanced relationship, and put an ending to this connection. Am I right, Spirit? Is that what happened in the past? Anything else? Yes, it became too burdening for one person. There was only one person who was carrying all the weight of this connection for person A, I'm telling you this, whoever you are, Pisces or the cross watcher. But I think person B was holding all the weight. They were under pressure. They felt, if I don't put into this connection, where is the connection? I think somebody got tired here and decided, hey, I'm not going to be in this juggling kind of a relationship. I'm going to put it to an end and I'm going to walk away from this connection. So how do they feel? How does person A feel about person B now? The Tower in reverse and the Six of Swords in reverse. How do they feel now, Spirit, about this connection, about their person? They feel they've made a big mistake. They know that it is their fault that they allowed the Tower moment to happen and the relationship to crumble. Now this person is not emotionally happy and they know that their partner is the one where the sun shines from. Okay, but they also feel now, Six of Swords in reverse. It means something has gone the wrong direction. How do they see their partner then, Spirit? They feel their partner has no trust in them. They feel that their partner feels that they're very immature, they're very rash, they don't speak properly, they could be rude sometimes, and their partner doesn't want to be in this place where they are always feeling neglected and have kind of let it go and saying, hey, I'm not going to sit around and wait for you. I'm not going to feel in neglect forever. That's how they see person B. Yes, they also see person B as getting out of a place where maybe person A never really showed them emotions or always emotionally manipulated them. They see their partner as not waiting around in regret and sorrow and upset. And they also feel that maybe their partner has now lost their love for them, because now there is nothing coming from person B's end towards them. Okay, so let's see how person B is doing. Person B is not fighting for this connection anymore with the Nine of Wands energy and the Strength card. They feel this was a very toxic relationship, even though there was a lot of maybe sexual attraction between the two of you. They are holding back from... they've turned their back. They've turned their back. They are... they may be moving towards new love now. At least that's what they want to. They feel this past relationship was very toxic. And there's no point waiting around or holding on to it. This person is trying to be strong now. And either they are hoping that person A comes back with an emotional offer, or they are happy now to move ahead to some new love here. Is that right, Spirit? Is that what they want to do? The Strength card. Strength card. Yes, they've made a decision now to protect their energy here. They've made a decision, I'm going to protect my energy, I'm going to be strong now, and if it means that means I have to turn my back on somebody I'm very attracted to, yes, but it's turning toxic, I'm going to keep myself strong, turn my back, and I'm going to now maybe move towards a new love in my life. Why do they feel like this? Because in the past, I think they did offer love, and... it turned out to be a very imbalanced relationship. Yes, they felt that one person was always kind of making them feel less than. It's like the same card here. Person said, maybe I don't feel good enough for you. Or maybe, what was it? I'm still fighting with my inner demons, but I feel I wasn't good enough for you. And the guilt of wondering whether I walked away too soon. So this person feels that, you know, in the past... Now they're realizing that this was a very imbalanced relationship. One person always had the upper hand. One person always had to win at all costs. They would sometimes be, they could do, say anything as long as they were victorious. So now they're recognizing the fact that this was a very imbalanced relationship. And this Page of Cups, Spirit? What's this Page of Cups in the past? Yes, I think in the past, person B did offer love to person B, they didn't want to be alone, and maybe they offered, let's be together, let's be in a commitment. They thought that person A was their wish fulfillment, but somebody kind of mistreated this connection. And now person B is recognizing that there was a lot of imbalance in this situation. So how do they see person A spirit? How does person B see person B? They see person B as the death card and the knight of wands. Yes, they feel that this has already come to an end. They feel rejected by person A, and they are sitting in there. They're not happy. They feel that this person B has put an end to this connection now, or maybe it's time that a death would be put to a connection like this, because they feel their partner is very, very immature. Again, the knight of wands in reverse. This is a card of sometimes a player who's immature, who's not stepping up to the plate, who's just wanting to have fun and never be a responsible adult. So this is how person B sees their person. They also see them that, you know, I've offered my love, but this person never accepts me. And they see their partner as always creating delays to get this connection moving and never offering them that love. It's like one person always has been there offering this love, but the other person they see has never offered this love or this apology back. So let's see, what's the action person A would take if they could or would? The devil, my God. Why is the action person A wants to take towards their partner the devil spirit? One more. Now they see person A as to what they've become. Now they see person B as the Empress, and I had the Empress here twice. Now they've recognized this person to be the best. Now they want to move towards person A. They want to send in a message. They want to say, hey, I want to work on this connection. I want to be with this Empress. Only because now I think they are very, very fearful that their person has, the blindfold is off. And that person sees them as they truly are and is no longer fretting and fuming or waiting for them. I think they're afraid. They're very, very afraid and become very obsessed that I better start kind of working towards this connection now, or I'm going to lose this Empress now, who I think is the best thing since sliced bread. Okay. Yeah, this person, one second. Anything else? Any action that person A wants to take? They just don't know how to now. They're kind of going back and forth in their mind as to how and what to say now. Okay, so what does person B want to take? They don't want to make any decision at all. They've blindfolded themselves. They don't want to make a decision. After all the hurt and pain that they've been through, they are not going to be juggled once again by person B. By person A, right? So person B is not in a place where they just don't want to see, they don't want to think. They are manifesting something. What is that? What is person B trying to manifest, spirit? No, they see their partner as a magician. I'm sorry. Person B sees their partner as a magician, always creating illusions and then creating fights and bringing imbalance into this connection. So they feel, I think the choice is clear. I think I don't need to go back anymore. I think it's time to kind of put a halt to this connection, and I'm not confused anymore. I think I know that I'm not supposed to do anything. Let's see, let's take one more one. What is the action person A wants to take, spirit, now? What's the action person A wants to take now? They want to go and speak their truth. They don't want to keep any more secrets. They want to reveal all. They want to tell person B that, you know, you're the one and I want to work on this connection with you. Basically, that they are afraid now with the devil energy and they don't want to have regrets or they don't want stress in their life. So they feel it's better that I go and tell person B before I lose them completely. And person B, spirit? Person B, what action would they like to take towards person A? Person B is saying, I'm not making any decision. If you're not coming back with the Ten of Pentacles for me, I'm releasing you. They're happy to release the connection, which is only going to keep them juggled or keep them unsafe now. They want the whole Monty or nothing else. So yes, it's time to speak your truth and ask for what you want. Instead of wasting time, Pisces, stay in your Empress energy and speak your truth. So that's all I have for you, Pisces. Love and light. Take care. Namaste. See you soon.